uJesuwa uyaphila ngiyokwesaba toni na. I would sing further, but apparently it's not my strengths. Good morning once again to everyone. We're so excited this morning to come to you on this beautiful, special Resurrection Sunday. It's a beautiful Sunday for us as the body of Christ because it speaks of not only the birth, death, burial, but the resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We are so excited this morning to know ukuthi sikhonza uJesu owafa kodwa zankafe kuphela wabuye wavuka ekufeni. And ngoba wavuka ekufeni, that speaks a lot to us as the body of Christ. And this morning, it's such a great joy. I know we're in a space as a country where our honorable president has extended the lockdown. And ours is really to support as best as we can to continue to pray, continue to do our due diligence and abide to the resurrection regulations that have been put in place for us during this time. Stay at home, be safe for those who are working as best as you can. Please remain safe during this time. And over and above that, Jesus remains on the throne, remains far above all principalities, rulers, and every force of darkness. And this morning on this beautiful Resurrection Sunday, I want to come and speak to us this morning about what the resurrection means for us as abantwana bakaNkulunkulu, as to how the power of this resurrection enables us to be the best that God has created us to be. I'm going to read from the book of Colossians chapter 3, verses 1 to 3. It reads thus. It says, "If then you were raised with Christ, seek those things which are above, where Christ is sitting at the right hand of God. Set your mind on things above, not on things on the earth, for you died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God." Hallelujah. One of the most beautiful things about the resurrection is for us to understand that because Jesus rose again, we will also rise. And this brings a lot of comfort to us as abantwana bakaNkulunkulu during this time. For us to understand that because Jesus Christ rose from the dead, he rose from the ashes of defeat. As a country, as a nation, given the space that we're in, we're gonna rise. Whatever dream that has died in your life, it's gonna rise. Whatever anointing you might have lost, if you might have backslidden, if you might have gone astray, but I want to assure you that ngoba wavuka nathi sizovuka. This is a message of hope to us that continues to remind us ukuthi because we serve a God who rose again from the dead, ayikho into angakwazi ukuyivusa. Wafika ethuneni laka Lazarus 4 days, bathi kuye sekayanuka. And he gets there, they say he is already stinking, there's a stench. And he asks them, "Where have you put him?" And they say to him, "But he is dead," because we serve a Jesus. And he gets to them and he says, "I am the resurrection and the life. I don't care how long it's been dead. I don't care if there's a smell around it," because even in your life this morning, I want to encourage you. I don't care what might have died. I don't care ipung esel corner around you, around your space, but we serve uJesu who is the resurrection and the life. Him who is able to get to a space, and when he gets there, he says, "Arise." He says, "Lazarus, come forth." And when he said that to Lazarus, he came out, and as he came out, scripture says, as he came out, he said to the guys, "Remove the stone, roll it away. Because one of the things about the resurrection of Christ, it causes things to roll away which have been holding us back, things which have been limiting us, things which have been causing us not to maximize our full potential in God. But because of the resurrection, kunabantu ekumele ukuthi kube yibo ebasusa lelitshe and roll it away. Then he says to them, here he is bound, he is alive, but he is still bound. And he says, "No, mthukululeni, untie him from these grave clothes." And I love this because one of the things about the resurrection of Jesus Christ, it causes us to be undressed from all of our past. That is why Paul says in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verses 17, that if any man be in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has passed away. Behold, the new has come. Because the thing that resurrection does for us, it causes ukuthi impilo yakudala isuke kithi. Ingakathi umhlabeleli njengenhlukano yempumalanga nentshonalanga zikude le kanjalo. That's how far he removes our sins, transgressions and iniquities from us. So because he rose, you will definitely also rise again. And one of the things as well I love and I want to draw our attention to in terms of the resurrection is the resurrection. When we read in the book of John chapters 20, it speaks of in the morning when Mary came to the tomb and the disciples got there. And scripture says, when they got there, verses 3, Peter therefore went out and the other disciple and were going to the tomb. So they both ran together and the other disciple outran Peter and came to the tomb first. And he stooping down, looking in, saw the linen cloths lying there, yet did not go in. Then Simon Peter came following him and went into the tomb and he saw the linen cloths lying there and the handkerchief had been around his head, not lying with the linen cloths, but folded together in a place by itself. And one of the things I just want to draw our attention to here is how scripture says, John got there and he stood outside and he looked at the tomb and looked what was happening inside. And this speaks of how a lot of people, to them, resurrection is a space for them to look and observe and see and hear and look at all the fuss of what we are doing as the body of Christ. But for some of us, resurrection is not just a sight for us to behold, but it's a point of entry into the tomb of Jesus Christ, where we begin to identify with him. The word of God further says, when they got there, Mary, verse 10, it says, she stood outside the tomb weeping, and as she wept, she stooped down and looked into the tomb, and she saw two angels in white, one sitting at the head and the other at the feet where the body of Jesus had lain. And this is also important for us to understand, because this points as well to remind us that Jesus is the ark of God, because in the ark would have the mercy seat and there would be two angels, one on the far end, the other on the far end. And this we see in the tomb of Jesus, where one angel was facing the other where the body of Jesus was lying. And this speaks to us of how Lord Jesu wethu esimkhonzayo, he is the ark of God. Not only the ark of God that was buried, but the ark of God that lives within us. The ark of God that we carry in our mortal bodies. In conclusion, one of the things I love about the resurrection of Jesus Christ is that this resurrection speaks of restoration. In the book of John chapter 21, we see Peter, who was one of the disciples of Jesus Christ, who had betrayed Jesus. Jesus told him, Peter, you're going to deny me three times. And Peter said, no, Jesus, you know, I can't deny you. I won't deny you three times, because you are the one who I love. Where you go, I will go. Where you die, I will die. And Jesus said, Peter, I'm telling you, three times the cock crowed, he denied him. And we find in the book of John 21, Peter, he's throwing in the towel. He's like, guys, I'm done. I've denied Jesus. He ain't coming back. I'm going fishing. And the guys followed him. And as he's going fishing, that's when Jesus appeared to them. And as he appeared to them, we see Jesus restoring Peter. Because had Jesus not resurrected from the dead, Peter would not have been restored. Peter would have lived his whole life thinking he's a failure. He sold Jesus. He betrayed Jesus. But through the resurrection, he was able to be restored. Why is it important for Peter to be restored? It's important because Peter is the one who carries the keys to the kingdom. Upon this rock, Peter, I will build my church. It is you, Peter, who needs to preach a message in the book of Acts chapter 2, and thousands, 3,000 get saved. It is you, Peter, who needs to define what I'm doing in the early church. It is you, Peter, who needs to tell them that this is that. We are not drunk, but upon our sons and daughters, he said in the last days, he would pour out his spirit. It is you, Peter, who needs in the book of Acts chapter 3, when walking to the temple with John, as you walked together, in fact, ran together to the tomb. It is you guys who need to meet that blind guy and tell him, the lame guy, at the beautiful gate and tell him, silver and gold we do not have, but what we have, in the name of Jesus of Nazareth, rise up and walk. But you can't tell them in the name of Jesus if he had not resurrected, because he had to first die. And scripture says in the book of Philippians chapter 2, because he died, he was given the name above every other name, that at the mention, at the call of this name, every knee is to bow, every tongue is to confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God the Father. What am I saying to us this morning? I'm saying because he lives, you can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Even during this time, there's no need for you to fear. Because he rose again, we're going to rise again. Economically, we're going to rise. As a nation, we're going to rise. As the body of Christ, we are definitely going to rise. Won't you celebrate this morning as you enjoy this day that we serve uJesu owafa wabuye wavuka kwabafileyo. And if that spirit that raised Christ from the dead lives within you, it shall quicken your mortal body. My prayer for you this morning is that the Holy Spirit would begin to resurrect and revive everything in you which has died, so that God would get all the glory. God bless you. We love you so much. May the Lord continue to keep you. May the Lord continue to make his face shine upon you. May the Lord continue to enlarge your territory even during this time. Make sure you don't only go through this lockdown, but you grow through this lockdown. We encourage you to remain connected in prayer, in the word, in giving, and allow God to do what only he can do during this time. God bless you. Till we meet again, we love you so much. God bless. Thank you so much once again for joining us and being part of our service. We truly appreciate that. Thank you for making time to remain connected with us during this time. We encourage you as best as you can, stay safe, stay in the house, and continue to abide to the regulations which have been set in place by our leaders. And over and above that, remain connected in prayer, in the word, in giving, as the Holy Spirit lays it in your heart. I believe this message was a blessing to you. I encourage you to interact with us. Please share, like, comment. And if you maybe gave your life to Christ, or you wanna reconnect to Christ, you'd like us to help you grow, please inbox us. We are more than willing and glad to walk this journey with you. Till we meet again next week, same time, same place, remain connected.